Paper, your paper already?
It's nearly ready. It keeps curling up.
It's a curly one, that one, I'm sorry.
These are called Lucas-Carmichael numbers. So they're named after two very famous mathematicians, Edward Lucas and Robert Daniel Carmichael. So if you have a composite number, which we'll call n, and so it's got some prime factors. So we have a composite integer.
A number that's not prime.
It's not prime, right, because it's made up of prime numbers. It's made up of prime factors. Then what makes it a Lucas-Carmichael number is p plus 1 is a factor of n plus 1. Shall I give you an example?
Yes, please.
The smallest value n can have, actually, is 399. So it sort of gives you a flavour that these are not everyday numbers, right? They're not. There's 398 have gone before them without this being satisfied. So what are the prime factors of 399? Well, it's 3 times 7 times 19. So what do? I now add 1. It becomes 400. And 400 has factors of 4, which is 3 plus 1, 8, which is 7 plus 1, and 20. We know that 20 goes into 400. We know that 8 goes into 400, it goes 50 times, and we know that 4 goes into 400.
So they're not the only factors.
They're not the only factors, and they're not prime factors, of course. They are just the factors. But the key thing, the neat thing is that I've added 1 to the number, and it turns out that all the original prime factors, if I just add 1 to them, they are also factors of my new number. That's one example. Let's do another one. So 935, for example, that has prime factors, which are 5 times 11 times 17. And if I add 1, we get 936. And the factors of 936 include 5 plus 1, 11 plus 1, which is 12, and 17 plus 1, which is 18. You can play around with them as much as you like, but they're not that easy to find. So 2015, and if I add 1, then 2016. So this has got 4 digits, these have got 3 factors, and the smallest Lucas-Carmichael number with 5 factors is in fact 5, 8, 8, 4, 5. And that's made up of 5 times 7 times 17 times 23 times 43. And so if I add 1, then it has factors. 5 plus 1 is 6, 7 plus 1 is 8, 17 plus 1 is 18, 23 plus 1 is 24, and 43 plus 1. Is 44.
Are there a lot of these things? Do we know much about them?
I don't think a great deal is known about them, that they're there, they're out there, and they're not that common, I think. I think the idea of having a number made up of prime factors and adding 1 and all the prime factors, if you just add 1 to each of those prime factors, still remains a factor of that number. It's not at all obvious to me that it should do that, and in fact it's clearly not that common that it does it.
Numberphile is a collaboration with the Mathematical Sciences Research Institute. But it's also made possible thanks to you, the viewers, especially these people who've supported us on Patreon. Our thanks to them.
We could at least ask, as we go along in the sequence, do we get a new prime at each step?